Hello everyone, the last video revealed how luxury brands make money and the story behind them. So in this episode, I'm going to discuss what marketing strategies are used by luxury brands that can keep us buying their products. First of all, I want to ask you a question. What kind of cosmetics do you usually buy? That's right, lipstick. So today, I'm going to talk about lipstick marketing strategies and the king of luxury brands in lipstick marketing field, YSL and Tom Ford. As you may have noticed recently, fewer and fewer clothes are on sale in stores, which replaced by lipsticks and cosmetics. There are also many beauty bloggers on website, Li Jiaqi for example, who is known as the king of lipstick in China. So, why is lipstick so hot? It's essentially the lipstick effect. What is that? Economists have found that people tend to buy more lipstick when the economy is bad and most people are not willing to buy clothes, shoes, or handbags. For example, in 1996, when the Japanese economy was in recession, something amazing happened. Kimura Takuya's endorsement of the lipstick once sold out. Even if the brand just added 10 times the volume of production is not enough. Something similar happened in the United States in 2001. In the wake of the September 11 attacks and economic downturn, lipstick sales had magically doubled. So lipstick is a really amazing thing. In this principle, luxury brand plus lipstick is more popular. When you buy a lipstick of luxury brand, do you feel it's like picking up money? But the same luxury brand selling lipstick, not everyone is particularly successful. Hermes, for example, did not sell as well as it had hoped, and Burberry was also neglected. But there are two luxury brands that are really strong in lipstick marketing, which is YSL and Tom Ford. Not only have they sold a segment of nearly a billion clubs in China, but they have also managed to get young people crazy about them. So what's the differences between the marketing approaches of these two brands? Today, I would like to mainly give you an analysis of how YSL and Tom Ford do lipstick marketing in the Chinese market. Let's start with YSL. YSL lipstick has a gold tube style and it's so popular today that even boys know it. There's a period of time girls are determined that only accept YSL lipstick as a gift in China. How can this happen? Let me tell you the story behind the brand's makeup. The first story starts with YSL's founder. Yves Saint Laurent was a very interesting man. In 1977, for example, he produced a very special perfume called Opium, and he also had his models naked. In 1978, YSL launched its first gold tube lipsticks, so it actually has a long history. If you've heard of YSL, you must know the brand is very famous for its clothes and handbags, but its cosmetics line and clothing line belong to companies. Its ready-to-wear and handbag lines are owned by Kering, the parent group of Gucci, and beauty makeup line is actually belong to L'Oreal. Why is that? In 1999, YSL suffered something of a setback when all its business was sold to Kering Group. It could never have imagined that YSL was about to stir up the whole beauty industry. The real story began in 2008. L'Oreal, a famous consumer goods group, took a fancy to YSL's cosmetic line and offered to buy it for 1.15 billion euros. And to keep it separate from the fashion business, the beauty line is called YSL and the fashion line is renamed Saint Laurent. That's the reason why you saw the brand today with two different names. L'Oreal then spent 5 years reinventing YSL in Chinese market. Although L'Oreal bought YSL in 2008, the contracts of many YSL agents in China have not expired. What is an agent? That is, the people who can use the name of YSL brand to set up shops, and they have a license from their company to sell YSL goods. L'Oreal wants to position YSL as a very on-market, young, and avant-garde brand. But wouldn't it spoil its brand image if there were too many agents selling YSL outside? So L'Oreal decided not to rush to make money. It was a very wise step. They chose to endure until all the contracts of agents expired in 2011. L'Oreal has only just begun to truly take the brand back in China, giving it a move over and taking 2 years to get it back online in 2013. L'Oreal also has good luck, choice is more than effort. It not only did not miss anything in 2013, but ushered in the dividend period of China's cosmetics market, and the market size also increased year by year. Since that year, L'Oreal has been expanding its presence in the Chinese market. The first move of YSL, How You Marketing? At the end of 2013, if you remember, that was a Korean drama on all kinds of platforms in China, You Who Came From the Stars. At the time, the show was a hit for a few things, fried chicken and beer, Jimmy Choo heels, and the gold tube lipstick from Qian Songyi. YSL gold tube lipstick used by Qian Songyi all the time was implanted as a strategy of L'Oreal. All we media are discussing the lipstick, which is out of stock for a long time. How many people still remember the fear of being dominated by a star's color? At the end of 2014, a dry maple color of lipstick also appeared in a Korean drama. Many people call it Kilman color in China, which is an exaggeration to say that men will be attracted by you as long as you put on this lipstick. And that's not all. YSL has come up with a second movement, one that has a lot to do with men. The second move of YSL, Jade Men Marketing. Obviously, it is to sell lipsticks to girls, but YSL has launched an event marketing aiming at male gifts. YSL launched the YSL Huge Pro Contour Star Clash Edition lipstick in October 2016. All of a sudden, not only the girls remember YSL, they want YSL lipstick as Christmas gift, boys also remember to buy a YSL lipstick for their girlfriends as a Christmas gift. Since then, YSL has become the most well-known lipstick brand among the post-1995 generation of men. In addition, YSL is also targeting several important festivals for couples to give gifts, such as Valentine's Day and Qixi Festival, and popular topics that will never go out of style between couples. So when all the girls thank YSL for enlightening their boyfriends, don't forget to thank L'Oreal Group, the operator behind all of this. Another luxury brand that has come to the fore in the male beauty way is Tom Ford. The character of Tom Ford is similar to the founder of YSL. He is known for his notebooks, and the advertising campaigns are often controversial by him. For example, when he was at Gucci, he had models shape the private parts into a G-shape. It was a shock when it hit the fashion world. He's very avant-garde in thought. For example, he makes a young man kneel in front of a female model in a commercial, which subverts many stereotypes about gender. Tom Ford injecting his unique concept into his namesake brand Tom Ford in 2014. Then Tom Ford brought the male economy into full play. In 2014, Tom Ford launched Lips and Boys, a limited edition lipstick collection, a set of 15 mini lipsticks, each with its own color number. All the inspiration of creation comes from the men who appear in Tom Ford's life. Why did he do this? Who can be satisfied with one when he can have several at once, he said. Start with 50, keep the 25 most popular colors for each year, and then replace them with 25 new shades. I have to say this is really successful. I didn't miss it when girls from every corner of the globe rush out of fight for their boyfriends. His ad also showed very lustful heart. Each is a girl kissing with a handsome man. At that time, supermodel He Sui posted a message on Weibo, releasing 50 Tom Ford lipsticks in one breath with the compassion, see a boyfriend for a different shade. It has excellent brand genius such as bold style and respect for women. So much for the lipsticks marketing strategies of these two luxury brands. Do you know why would I do a story about luxury beauty? First of all, from the consumer's point of view, actually I want you to know there is a routine behind the brands and symbols you worship. We might not be so kidnapped by consumerism if we had a better understanding of the principles behind the cult of luxury brands. At the same time, I have a great respect for all marketers. What is a brand? Brand is a good product, the precipitation in time and space. What is marketing? Marketing is really about linking user needs with product values. There is nothing wrong with marketing, it's just make something good more visible. We love the brand not only because of the routine and brainwash, but also choose to respect it after the precipitation of time. Because the brand itself stands for trust and effort, there is also why I still choose to buy YSL and Tom Ford even though I know so many marketing tricks behind them. Because what I buy is the precipitance and trust behind it. See you next time!